practicing our tarot. Here with a monthly love scope for the zodiac sign of Sagittarius, sun, moon, and rising for the month of September 2018. Let's see what's going on with my Sagittarius. Spirit and universe, what are the messages you have for the zodiac sign of Sagittarius, sun, moon, and rising for the month of September 2018? Show me Sag. I'm going to do a 9-card spread, Sagittarius. Altogether, it'll be 18. I'm going to do a layover over top of that 9-card spread just in case I don't get your message the first time around. Okay, here we go. Knight of Swords. Two of Cups. And the Two of Pentacles. Six of Pentacles, Six of Cups. Okay, what's going on? You got soulmates and karmic partners and the Wheel of Fortune, the vertex. Yeah, well, you guys are still in a vertex because this is a fire sign vertex that's going on. So there is a lot of karmic soulmates, actual soulmates, life partners. That's also in the sign of Sagittarius, as well as Leo and Aries. Page of Wands. The Lovers. Look at that. This shit is beautiful. I like it. Okay, Linda. Oh, shit. I spoke too soon. The Ten of Swords. Overall energy at the bottom of the deck is the Three of Cups. There's a lot of infidelity in the zodiac sign of Sagittarius. A lot. Some of you Sagittarius are caught between a rock and a hard place. You're stuck between a soulmate and a karmic soulmate. Somebody's going to get hurt. Okay? It's inevitable. You know that. All right? But it kind of represents to me that spirit is forcing you at this moment to cut off maybe even a soulmate. It may be the soulmate that you have to cut off. Why? Well, because you have to take care of the karmic energy between you and your karmic soulmate so that you can get to the life partner, the twin flame. Okay? That's necessary. That's how it goes. And a lot of you could be very sad about that because, you know, with your soulmate, you may have known this person a very long time. This person been in your life for a while. So you love them, you know? That's a love unlike any other. It's very comfortable, but it's not beneficial to nobody but yourself. And I try to tell people that. You know, with soulmates, it does God no good, okay? Or it does spirit no good, okay? It's for you, all right? It's perfect. You guys are just alike. You love each other. You know each other. You like the same shit, okay? But it doesn't help anybody else but you. Unless you're actually in on a soulmate lifetime, then chances are you won't marry your soulmate and spend the rest of your life with that person, okay? I kind of get the sense that this is hurting you really badly, and it could be because your soulmate, you got into a fight or an argument. There's an argument here. And it could be that your soulmate is checking your ass because you're spending more time or more energy and putting more effort into the karmic soulmate, okay? And they're a little upset with you. They're jealous. Maybe they feel like they're always there for you. They're always there to spend money on you or take care of you or whatever the fuck they're doing. And they're frustrated because you're not giving the same in return. This is deep as shit because I also have another story here. I have a... There are some Sagittarius out there that may be in a relationship where you're just using a person for money and fame or some shit like that. Okay? And then you have your karmic soulmate that you're not done with, that's frustrated with you. Somebody's disappointed at you this month, Sagittarius, because you have to cut someone off, all right? You're going to have to cut off one of these people. And I honestly feel like it could be the actual soulmate that you cut off, because maybe you created some karma or something with another person. Maybe you're having a baby this month. I don't know. Maybe there's a baby. You found out someone was pregnant. Okay. And you have to cut off your lifelong soulmate. And they're devastated about that. And that could hurt you as well. You had to make a choice. I got to get more cards on this, because this is like, I mean, I get the point. It's two different people, two very important people, a soulmate and a karmic soulmate. And it looks like there's a fight that went down, an argument, some sort of argument. The person that got hurt in this situation is devastated because you chose to stay with the karmic soulmate or whatever. Give me more clarity on this story. I gotta see more clarity. I'm nebby, so I like to see what the fuck is going on, okay? So let's pull. Give me additional messages on the sign of Sagittarius. The Page of Swords. So this is secrecy. Page on top of the Knight. This is secrecy. Okay, what's the secrecy about? Let's see. The Four of Swords. Okay, so maybe there was somebody in your life that you weren't communicating with. Okay, why wasn't they communicating with him? Come on. The King of Wands. Okay, maybe it's a fire sign like yourself. Or it could even be you. Maybe you took a break on a certain relationship because you got motives. What's the motive? Because see, that Six of Pentacles being there, Two of Pentacles. On the Six of Pentacles. You got two people in your life, and they serve different purposes. One of them is your childhood sweetheart, the one that you see a future with, the one that you want to marry. But as of right now, it kind of looks like you have to cut that person off. Seven of Pentacles. Because you got a baby on the way. That's what it is, Sag. Some of you have a baby on the way. This is for my men. Some of you Sagittarius had to cut off a soulmate or somebody that you're in love with, okay? And you took a back seat. You haven't been contacting them. You haven't been calling them because maybe you recently found out that you have a child on the way. So this soulmate connection, and this could even be a life partner. It may be a life partner because the Seven of Pentacles with the Two of Pentacles here, it kind of represents that. Just hold up a minute. I have to go through my karma. I have to clear up my karmic energy before I could actually have you. Look at this. The Lovers is coming again. We got the Nine of Wands. Oh, no. Well, no, it's not. The Nine of Wands. I'm going to take it anyway because the Lovers was coming. And then the Lovers. Nine of Wands with the Lovers. This is a repetitive relationship. It could even be with a fire sign. It could be fire on fire. Two fire signs that are madly in love with each other. Been doing this for a very long time. It could even be a life partner. But that life partner has to take a back seat so that you can deal with this karmic partner. This karmic partner looks like they're pregnant. So Sagittarius, some of you have someone pregnant, okay? And the others of you, you have someone pregnant. And you have to put your life partner on a back burner. But they understand this, even though it's going to hurt really bad. It's going to hurt you probably more than them. You just have to put them on a back burner. You must be very young. Because this person's really not going to go nowhere. Even though they're on a back burner right now, you'll come back to this individual. The Death card, see? You'll come back to this individual a little later after you've matured, after you've grown up. The Hierophant, told you this is a life partner. On the Lovers, this is a life partner. Some of you have to take a back seat from your life partner. Okay, you're in the middle of the vertex, and this vertex has brought with it karmic energy. Maybe because, and this is the reason. Hold, let me pull the last card, and I'm gonna tell you why. Temperance, you see that? And then, what is the overall energy? Give me the overall energy. The Three of Wands. Okay, now listen. this vertex that just hit for us, okay, it kind of represents to me, a lot of you Sagittarius may have been on and off with your life partner for a very long time. You love this person. This is your pride and joy. This is the person that you grew up with. This is the person that you see your future with, okay? The problem is, what happens is, when you find that life partner, you never want to detach from that individual. And you start to have all kind of problems. The longer you hold on to that relationship, you start to have all kind of problems. Why do you have problems? Well, because there's karmic energy that the two of you created from previous lifetimes that you have to go and you have to take care of, okay? When this happens, this is why they call it life partnership, because you separate. So you may have had 10 years together, and then you separate for about 3, and then maybe you'll come back together for a year, and then you separate again. And this is the way it goes with life partners. It's not like where you're completely on and you just spend the rest of your life with this person. A life partner goes with you throughout your entire life. And depending on how long it takes you to clear up that karmic energy, how long it takes you to realize who you are, to realize who this life partner is to you, okay, and quit romanticizing things, okay, is determined on how long it's going to take for you guys to go into union. Sagittarius, this vertex has brought with it, for a lot of my men, Sagittarius, brought with it a child. It could even be females as well. Some of you got pregnant, and you got pregnant by a karmic soulmate. Spirit did this so that the two of you, your life partner and you, can break away, because that bond is too hard to break. We have the Nine of Wands with the Lover's card. So this is like obsession. This is like, I cannot leave this. Even if it's falling apart and it's not working, I cannot leave her. I cannot leave him. I love this motherfucker with everything in me. I can't let this go. So Spirit had to bring something as strong in order to split the two of you. Okay, and for a lot of you, especially you younger ones, okay, under 40, maybe up to 45, they had to bring about a baby, okay, in order to split the two of you, okay. Other than that, they wouldn't have got you separated. It also looks to me that you had to move away from your life partner. So the Sagittarius that I'm talking to, you may have recently moved out of the state that your life partner lives in, okay. You may have moved. Maybe you moved in with the person that you recently gotten pregnant. That sort of thing. And it kind of looks like to me that initially, looking at this Six of Pentacles, maybe initially you was only going after this sad person, which happened to be a karmic soulmate, for money. That's the way it looks. I'm being honest. It looks like maybe you were only going after this sad person for money. Maybe you were hit. You had a hard time financially. You were struggling with your life partner. You guys didn't have money. Or maybe your life partner told you, you know, get it how you live. Because, see, life partnership, that's that Bonnie and Clyde type of energy, okay? So they don't really give a fuck if you go out and use somebody for money. You know, any means necessary. Especially if they're a Sagittarius like you. It's any means necessary. So you may have gotten into something that looked very promising. Maybe you got with a woman that had a really good job. They had the opportunity to get you in the company. Maybe you got with some fucking celebrity. I don't know. What do I know? Maybe you got with someone that had that public grounding, okay, to really take you to another level. But then, right when you was supposed to return to your life partner, maybe they got pregnant. So it's something that trapped you temporarily. It's not going to trap you forever, because you're going to be with your life partner regardless. You know, after this karmic energy pass, after you teach this karmic partner whatever lesson that you're supposed to teach them, and they teach you whatever lesson they're supposed to teach you, then you guys will move on and you'll go back to your life partner. That's why that Seven of Pentacles is there, because your life partner has to wait and not hear from you. Okay? They may not hear from you for a while. All right? Yeah, life partner got away. Also, when you see the Hierophant, remember that it's a teaching mechanism. When I see the Hierophant, a lot of times I know that Spirit is working. I know that this is a life lesson. This is a lesson that I'm supposed to learn down here on the physical planet. Okay? So whenever you see that Hierophant with that, know that they're involved, Spirit, guides, God, whoever you pray to, they're involved in this situation. Okay? So there's nothing you can do. The life partner that may be connected to the Sagittarius, but back up and let them learn their lesson. Okay? a harsh vertex. Just when I thought the Sagittarius didn't really have a hard time through this vertex, they're going through it. They're definitely going through it. Yeah, because looking at that Wheel of Fortune, originally you may have only been looking to get the coin from the person that you're connected to. Okay, for you and your life partner. Because it looks like you took care of your life partner, or you make sure that they have everything they want. But then things change. The wheel spent. And it left you kind of fucked up. It left you having to stick with that person. The same person that you were using is the same person that you ended up stuck with. Okay? That's deep. That is deep, Sag. For my singles, what I would tell you is a lot of you have two choices between a soulmate and a karmic soulmate. And then there are those of you that are involved with a life partner and a karmic soulmate. But if you're involved with a life partner, trust me, you already know. Okay? And then, you know, those of you that are single, you don't have anybody right now. It kind of looks like for the month of September, it's going to spin. So there's going to be an opportunity for two of them to come in, the karmic soulmate and the soulmate. Which one are you going to choose? Okay? So don't think, you know, you're just hearing this. This is August, what, 27th? You're just getting this reading. Don't think that singles, you don't have nobody. Well, fuck it, I'm not going to get anybody because she's talking to couples. No, Linda, I'm talking to your ass too. Okay, come September, when you find yourself running into a soulmate and a karmic soulmate together, you know, like for instance, in the month of August, July going into August, it was all about Leo. Leo was really hitting that vertex. Right now, Aries is having a great time. They're falling in love. And they're happy. September hits. Now the vertex is spinning and is fucking with Sagittarius. Okay. Within the next couple months, it's going to go around and it's going to fuck with Aries. Okay. So every fire sign is going to feel it. Okay. As well as water sign, because this is a fire and water vertex that's happening right now. Right now, it's still in the sign of Cancer. Okay. In September, well, we'll get to Pisces and all that. Let me do the readings first. It's still in the sign of Cancer. It did not hit Scorpio. It doesn't look like it's in Scorpio for September. Okay, so where's it going next? Pisces? Is it still going to be in Cancer? We'll find out. Okay, all right. I love you much. Definitely like, share, comment below, subscribe if you haven't already. If you want to hit me up for a personal reading, you can hit me at allseeingeyetarot@gmail.com, okay? And you can book a personal reading and we can talk about it, especially if you're knee deep in the vertex and you're like, my life is spiraling out of control. I don't know what the fuck is going on. Bella, help me out. I'm here for you, okay? Hit me up, book your personal reading. I'll get you in. We'll talk about it, okay? Until next month. Thank you, Sag.